Max MSP is a graphical programming environment for music, audio, and multimedia. Max is a standalone application developed by Cycling74. Max for Live is the integration of Max with Live. In this video, we will cover the basics of Max, which work just the same in Live. The main document type that we work with in Max is called a patcher. When we create a new patcher, we get a large empty window, which we then populate with objects that we connect together to make larger programs. From the top bar, we can add various types of objects. The left bar gives us access to various types of content. In the bar on the right, we will find various tool windows, and at the bottom are functions that we use while patching. Let's create a button by using the top bar. We can resize objects. We can move them around on the screen. And normal clipboard functions like cut, copy, paste, and delete work as expected, so we can make more than one button by pasting it over and over. We connect objects by dragging a patch cord from the outlet of one to the inlet of another. We can then take the patcher out of edit mode, or in other words, lock the patch, and interact with objects using the cursor. Different objects provide different functions. For example, let's create a toggle switch. A toggle is used to start and stop different behaviors in your patch. At the far left of the top bar is the object box. We use the object box by typing in words. These words load small programs, which are then used to build larger ones. A metro object, set to 350 when turned on with the toggle, will provide a metronome that sends out a message called a bang at regular intervals of 350 milliseconds. Clicking on the toggle will send a message of 1 to the metro to activate it, and a few times a second we'll see the lights flash on the buttons. If we want to get help on any object, we can Alt or Option click it. A help file will come up that is actually a full functioning Max patch. We can also open up a reference page, which gives us a lot of information about any object we want, as well as links to tutorials and other objects we might need to know about. A very common object that we use in Max is called the message box. We can write anything we like, and when we click on it, the message will be sent to the receiving object. If we want to work with multimedia, Max has a number of objects to choose from. The iMovie object loads in a movie, which we can then work with in our patch. When we click on the message box, it instructs the iMovie object to read in a movie. A lot of what we do with Max is work with numbers. The random object will generate a random number whenever we send it a bang, which we can then view using a number box. If our patch starts to get messy, it's easy to clean it up. We can highlight a group of objects and align them. If we like orderly connections, we can use segmented patch cords by holding Shift while clicking the outlet. As you can see now, we're generating a random number. What we're going to do with this random number is send it into the iMovie object. The iMovie object will interpret the random number as a point in time to jump to in the film. A counter object will simply count between the two numbers we give it, in this case, 60 and 72. We're going to use this to create a note on-off pair for a MIDI synthesizer. The makeNote object generates the notes. And the noteOut object sends them to the built-in synthesizer in the computer. So now we have an ascending scale repeating over and over again. And it's always important to save our work. This should cover the basics of Max. If you want to know more, you can find in-depth Max tutorials here. Before we start working with Max in Live, let's briefly cover some of the differences between Max and Max for Live. To work with Max as a standalone application, you will need a license which you can purchase at cycling74.com. However, if you own Live Suite, you also own a Max for Live license. This means that when we open Max to edit a Max for Live device by pressing this special icon in the top right, then we can make changes and save the device. Lastly, if we want to start a new Max for Live device, instead of creating a new patch from the file menu, we have to start in Live and use a default device as a starting point. Max patch files have the MaxPat extension, whereas Max for Live device files have the AMXD extension. Happy patching!